All right, what's up, y'all? Welcome to episode 1 of Powerlifting America Nats Prep. We got heavy squats today. Just hit my top single, 672. Probably like RPE 7-ish, maybe 7.5. But we'll keep it there, keep back down chill, and then we're gonna save some juice for deadlifts on Thursday. Back at TSS, we got a heavy bench today, heavy bench single. And last week I didn't post any bench on Instagram or on fucking on YouTube. I like recorded some stuff, but I ended up not posting it. But ever since I switched my squat position, like my squat head position, and now I have like a slightly more upright torso, the bar started to slip down my back more into my palms, and I was stressing my forearms a lot. So when I went to bench last week, my forearms were just wrecked. I couldn't like control anything over like 315 to the chest. Really, I was kind of just having to dump the last little bit. And so I wanted to address that quick. So I told Joey, and we decided to switch my secondary squat day to like a mid bar, high bar. So that's like a first like easy fix you can make. If you can still progress your squat that way, that's like an easy fix you can make to take some stress off the elbows or forearms or biceps, whatever's hurting. And then the second thing I'm doing, I'm making sure to chalk my back really good so the bar doesn't slip as much. And then I'm just being really intentional with getting my upper back tight. Like some shit you learn like when you first start squatting low bar to get your upper back tight. And I just wasn't really doing it too much. So I've been real intentional with that, trying to bring my scaps back, really get my upper back as tight as possible, and then create that shelf so the bar doesn't slip down as much. That's what I did yesterday. And forearms were already feeling a lot better during that squat session. But we'll see today. We'll see today as I start warming up if I'm feeling anything. I'm really hoping for like a 460 plus, a clean 460 plus, because I got a 7.8 today. But we're just going to take what's there. And yeah, that's it, man. Let's get it. What's up, boys? Solid bench session. Forearm still bugging a lot, way better than last week. Last week I couldn't control the weight to my chest at all. This week it was better, but still affecting those top singles. So I only was able to go up to 457 today. The weight didn't really feel too heavy on the press. I just lacked tightness like to the chest, like that last little bit to the chest. I can't really maintain my full tightness because my forearm's hurting. So I'm gonna give it like another week, see if these little tweaks I made with the technique, obviously with the split, if that helps enough to where I feel 100% on Tuesdays. But if not, I'm just gonna move this bench day from Tuesday, which is my primary bench day, obviously, I'm gonna move that to Wednesday and then I'm gonna just hit accessories on Tuesday, give my forearms a little bit more time to rest in between the heavy low bar, and then just see what we could do there. I don't think this is gonna be like a long-term issue. I think it's just something that's coming up because my squats got really heavy quick, and it's like with this new technique where my forearms are having to take more load with the bar sliding down. So I don't think it's gonna be something that lasts forever. It's just right now they're having to adjust, but that's all I got. I'm hungry as hell, so I'm gonna go make some food at the crib. I'll probably see y'all tomorrow. Had one of my guys ask me the other day, because I put him on some new macros, and I put him on like 300 carb, and I think usually he was used to eating like 200. And so for breakfast, he had like 2 cups of oatmeal and just like heavy ass carbs. And then he tried to go train 2 hours later, and he was like, bro, I felt like shit. So I was like, so he wanted me to lower his carbs, but I was like, bro, just try this first. This is what I eat pretty much every time I train. So like on my off days, but accessory days, I'll eat something else. But whenever I'm hitting like big movements and I don't want to be bloated, I eat this pretty much every session. So it's just 2 bananas, 2 scoops away. And then this is like 50 carbs worth of Gatorade. I eat that like an hour before I'm gonna leave to the gym. And that'll be like fully digested by the time I get to the gym. And then I drink my pre and I'm straight, no bloating. I got like 110-ish carbs in me from the bananas and the Gatorade. Yeah, pretty much perfect meal if you train like an hour or two within like when you're waking up. If you train later in the day, then it's whatever, you can eat whatever. But yeah, I'm about to knock this meal out. Hit about an hour, maybe less. Just knock out some messages upstairs. And then I'll see y'all at the gym. What's up, y'all? Just finished up at the gym. We had deadlifts and bench today. Been here for almost, I think, like right at 3 hours now, so I'm fucking starving. But hit 815 for the top single. In the back of my head, I had 855 like as a goal for the day, which would have obviously been at 10 if I did hit it, and just probably not smart. So I hit the 815 and I felt just like a small tweak, or not tweak, but like tender spot in my back, like in between my ribs. So I was like, all right, let's just call it there. Still a solid top single. And then I was able to hit a PR on the back downs after that. So probably if I would have went 855, one, if I even was able to pull it, but even if I was able to hit it, wrist tweaking the back, and then the back down work was not gonna be that good. So happy with the day. I'm starving. I'm gonna go get some food. So I'm gonna close the video out here. Appreciate y'all watching. Leave a comment. Let me know what y'all want to see in the next video. Like, subscribe, all that good stuff. I'm out.